Hey YouTube, well, back on the Scout, man. I can't tell you how stoked I am to be back riding. I was like a month down without that battery. God, that drove me insane. All this beautiful weather, and I'm stuck in a car. It's good to be out riding again, for sure. The weather's still good here in Italy. I still gotta get my tires mounted. That's next on the list. Get that worked out here in the next week or so. But yeah, man, it's nice to be riding. I got my backrest on. That feels good. Phone charging on my USB port. That's nice. Brand new battery. Don't have to think about that. Oh yeah, it's good. So I wanted to take a second here and answer a viewer question. Roknwoe asked, after watching my video about why I bought a Scout or an Indian and not a Harley Davidson, and he asked, well, you know, what are my thoughts about the Indian? Well, I want to say first, this is the only Indian I've ridden. I have not ridden the 111 bikes, so I don't have anything to compare that to. I have not ridden any of the brand new Harley Davidsons, so this is not a comparison to that. This is just talking about what I like about this bike. There's a few things that are a little, I would have liked it a little different, but it is what it is. The Scout has a lot going for it, for sure. I really like it. It's for the price, you know, with the ABS on this bike, I paid $12,900, you know, a year and a half, 2 years ago now. I think the price is about the same. I don't know if they've gone up at all. Maybe they've got some features on some new bikes that bring up the price, but you know, overall, it's been really, really good. I love the power. You know, talking about, real quick, you know, the engine in this bike being overhead cam definitely is different. You get a lot of high-end RPM, which is nice, so you can really rev this thing up. And the power comes on late. It's got a lot of torque at the bottom, so you don't have to worry about getting out of the hole. That's not an issue, but it really revs up. Comes near 9 grand. One thing I do wish this bike had was a proper tachometer. It has a digital tach, but I can't see that thing, man. I need out of the corner of my eye or needle heading into the red, and that might be something I'm gonna work on adding to this bike at a later time, and maybe even a shift light, just because I don't want to have to be looking down for that shift point. I just want to go, and I don't want to have to think about it. So I wish this thing had a proper tach. I wish it had a gas gauge. I'm getting about, I don't know, 115 miles out of a tank with two people on it. And usually that's probably, you know, a lot of cruising, but still getting on it here and there. So mileage is okay, I guess, for a tank. You know, I carry a can of gas just in case. Another reason I got my bags to lock up, so I don't lose my 1 liter of gas, my emergency can. You know, for the price point on this bike, I think that the paint jobs are absolutely amazing. This thing came like a pool of paint. It looked like it was wet. The chrome over the top. The chrome on this bike is just, looks like you could fall into it and just drift away. I think that they give you, this Indian gives you a decent amount of accessories, and now that there's a lot of companies making accessories, a lot of companies making bags and aftermarket windshields, and Kiriakin's making parts, and so that's really good. Performance wise, this thing's quick, man. I mean, I know no matter what I say, guys on the jigsers and all these crotch rockets, these guys are gonna be like, oh man, that bike's slow. Yeah, well, you know, for a cruiser, it's quick, man. It's quick. Don't be fooled. Is it jigsaw quick? Well, I'm not drag racing this thing. And I'm also not canyon racing this thing. But I can put my wife on the back, and I still got plenty of power to pass cars and run up to, you know, top speed and do whatever I need to do. Plenty of power, man. This thing is not short on power by any means. Even with all the gear I got in the windshield, this thing scoots, man. I have just no complaints in that department. Maintenance has been good. I mean, taking it to the dealer is a little pricey. I started doing my own oil changes, trying to get that price down. When I start doing some bigger rides next summer, I'll probably take it to the dealer and just have it all gone through for its scheduled maintenance. But other than that, I think this is a good bike. For my size, I'm 5'10", 180 pounds. Works good for me. Pulls hard. Comfortable riding position. This November 2017 will be 2 years since I've had the bike. And yeah, man, I have no complaints, no reservations. I know that, you know, right off the bat, I know for a fact that the guys who rode Victories took a lot of heat from the Harley guys, but that was an American made bike. You know, the Indian is an American made bike. I think it, you know, it should be respected. I'm not here to put down Harley Davidson or any people who ride whatever you ride. I don't care. You know, BMWs, Kawasaki's, Suzuki's, Hondas, Triumphs, Moto Guzzis, whatever you ride, man, enjoy it. And it doesn't even matter. Dirt bikes, street bikes, all kinds of stuff, man. I love bikes. I do. I love bikes. I love cars. I love anything that goes. I just always have ever since I was a kid.